Hello, I am Chris Menard. Great video today. I want to know if I can pull the list of the S&P 500 companies that I find on the web. Can I pull them into Excel? And then after I pull them into Excel, can I use Excel's stock data type with those? Let's give this a shot right now. I have Wikipedia running because it has a list of the S&P 500 companies. I believe there's actually 503. We're about to find out. I'm going to copy this URL up here, go over to Excel. I have Microsoft Excel running, blank worksheet. Let's go to the data tab and we want to pull from web. I'm going to paste the URL from Wikipedia in here. By the way, should be obvious, but you need an internet connection to do this. I did select basic, click OK. This is actually a perfect screen, even though it's not displaying the companies yet, because it found that web page, and that web page actually had multiple tables. Just really simple, just start clicking through them. That actually is the table right there, I believe. I'm just going to click on a couple other tables, just so you can see what it is doing in here. So all these tables that are displaying were tables on that web page. But for me, table one is the one I want. I've selected table one. I could go and transform the data. You would transform the data if possibly some values showed up as text or vice versa. I'm just going to go ahead and load this right now. Let's see what I get. This is perfect. Look over to the far right, queries and connections. And it's queries and connections. Can I connect it to that Wikipedia table? The table changes. I can refresh it over here, or it can automatically refresh. Up to you, but look how many rows I got, 503 rows. There is the data here. I'm going to pop back over to Wikipedia just for a second so you can see that it is the same information. My header row is in row one. There is your headquarter location, and then we have a date founded as the last column. Back over in Excel, we have the date founded in the last column. So this is great right here. Now, can I use the data types in Excel with this? I am going to, just to keep this simple, I'm going to copy all the stock symbols in column A. I'm going to go to a brand new worksheet and paste those. Make the word symbol bold. Click in your data, make it a table. Perfect. And now I'm going to select A2. Down to A504, I did A2, control, shift, down arrow to quickly select those. I'm going to go to the data type, and I'm going to select stocks. I'm getting another task pane to load because I still have queries and connections running. This, by the way, is actually working. Some of the stock types, it's not sure what to do. Notice I'm going to widen column A. A2 through A7 are perfect. It doesn't know what cell A8 is. You would come in here and fix that. AMD, select, perfect. It jumps to the next one. But it is working. You would need to fix the ones that it missed. And by the way, of the 503 out here, it did not miss many. Bonus question or bonus tip. I'm just going to close this right now. If you're wondering why are there 503, some stocks have multiple classes. I'll give you an example, Google. So let's just click and do Control F and just do G-O-O-G. Find next. Google is listed here in row 21 and row 22. I believe the other two, one is Fox. Look at row 206 and row 207, two different classes of stock. And the last one, I feel like it has to do with news. Row 340 and row 341. There you go. So that's why you have 503, but it's the S&P 500. What is cool now, though, is now that you've created a table, you went and found all the stock types, you could come in here and start using Microsoft Excel's stock data type, finding the prices, the previous close, the 52-week high, 52-week low. All of this information is now available to you right here. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I have online training available in Teams, OneNote, Copilot. Take care. Thank you.